Yo, what's going on? Welcome to the Sean Kearns Show. I am Sean Kearns. It is Sunday, March 19th, I think. I'm saying that off the top of my head. 2017. For those of you that don't know what year it is. Second episode. Episode 2. Very exciting. Thank you if you listened to the first episode. I got some pretty good feedback, all right? As you can tell, if you're on YouTube right now, I got video. I got some cameras, two cameras. And that's because most people that I talked to, they were like, "Oh yeah, I listened to some of your podcast." No one said I listened to your podcast. Everyone said I listened to some of your podcast. Or they said they had to watch it in increments. I don't know, maybe it's just too hot to handle. I'm not sure. Maybe people just don't have an hour of time to be listening to. I mean, I don't listen to podcasts. So I don't know when people find the time to, to listen to this, but thank you if you did. So yeah, I got two cameras here. Because I give the people what they want, you know? I give the fans what they want. So we got video. People also said they wanted me to have guests on. They thought it would be more interesting to have some back and forth. And you can go fuck yourselves with that, all right? No, I tried having a guest on last week, and it didn't go well, all right? We tried using two other cameras. I have GoPros now. We tried using some DSLR cameras, and they only record for 20 minutes at a clip, apparently. Mind you, he and I are both film majors, and so yeah, we only got like 20 minutes of video, but an hour of audio. And like the first 10 minutes, we were talking about how there were cameras, so I couldn't just post the audio, especially after I told everyone I was gonna have video. And also, I can't like really, I'm not that good of a host, apparently. I don't know what I'm doing, you know? I'm still trying to figure this shit out, all right? Rome wasn't built in a day, right? As they say. So yeah, I tried doing an episode last week. It just didn't go well. And of course, that was right after. No, that was right before. No, that was right after I had posted a picture of myself and captioned it saying, "Every Monday, the Sean Kearns Show will be, released every Monday." And then we try to do the podcast that weekend. Didn't work out. So the first Monday, I didn't even have a podcast, like after posting that I was gonna have one every Monday. So I mean, you're gonna hit a few speed bumps, right? And so but I'm doing it now. All right, you have to wait a week. The longer you wait, the better, right? Right? So yeah, happy St. Paddy's Day, right? I think the holiday is a bunch of bullshit. It's just an excuse for everyone to get smashed. You know? Everyone. So, besides me, of course. So I just gotta, I watch everyone else have a good time. No, I don't mind the holiday. I think it's cool. It's a good, excuse to, get drunk and like hang out and whatever, wear a green shirt. You drink your green beer, right? That's a good time. You know what bothers me? I don't like the hardcore Irish guys. You know, that just go, they fucking like live for the day of St. Patrick's Day, right? Wearing kilts. What do you're a grown ass man. Why are you wearing a kilt? All right, listen, just because I'm Irish doesn't mean I'm not gonna say it doesn't look weird. Okay? I think you look ridiculous. I think it's embarrassing. All right. Who what came first, the skirt or the kilt? All right? Because if the skirt came first, then you're just ripping off like women's clothing. That's like me walking around in a crop top now. Right? And even if you invented it first, isn't it like fucking 10 degrees in Scotland? Why are you making skirts or kilts or whatever the fuck? Wear sweatpants. Right? That's what I would do if I lived there. I would wear sweatpants. But So yeah, just grown-ass men walking around in kilts. Just like, we get it, all right? Well, you're Irish. Or Irish people, you know, they need to make a point that they're Irish on St. Paddy's Day. They need to remind you that you're Italian, or whatever the fuck, and that they're the real celebrators, is that a word, of St. Paddy's Day, you know? Like, relax. No one gives a shit that you're Irish. I'm 100% Irish. Who gives a fuck? Right? Like, who cares? Or Irish people, they just gotta, like, there's nothing that great about fucking Irish shit. All right? Like, what, you gotta drink Guinness? Guinness is average at best. It's not that great. Okay? You ever seen how Guinness is poured? You gotta, like, pour half one way, then you gotta let it sit, right, for like 2 minutes, and then you gotta, like, then you go to fill it, the other half back up, and you gotta, like, fucking pull the lever the other way. It's just a process for beer that is, like, it's whatever, I think. You know? It's like a light beer, but it's dark. It's confusing. All right? And it's, like, not that great. All right? And, like, corned beef and cabbage. That shit sucks. It's not even good. I mean, you're not ordering that any other day than St. Paddy's Day. Okay? There's a reason why, like, when you're like, oh, yeah, hey, you want to get Mexican tonight? Or, hey, let's get Chinese, right? You never like, hey, let's go to an Irish restaurant tonight. That doesn't happen, okay? Because Irish food sucks, all right? And, or like the bullshitters that drink, like, Irish whiskey, you know, like, oh, I gotta have a shot of JMO. That JMO sucks too, all right? That's one of those killers. That's one of, like, tequila. That's one of those shots you take and you regret it 2 seconds later, right? And then you have to, like, walk away. You have to walk away for a second, fucking try to, like, spit out saliva so you don't throw up. That's what that shot is. All right. So just because you're Irish, you don't have to drink it. It's not good at all. All right. There's a reason why Fireball is the most popular shot. And that's because it's bearable. You know, there's a lot of shots that are bearable, and Irish whiskey blows. So cut the bullshit, all right, with that, you know? And I was just like, you know, I'm 100% Irish. What's there to boast about? You know? Right? Being Irish sucks. You know what I have for being Irish? I have anger issues, alcoholism, and a receding hairline, all right, for being fucking Irish, okay, thanks, you know what I mean? I don't get what the whole hype is, and we have the fucking lame-ass stereotypes. Oh, Irish people drink beer? Everyone drinks beer, everyone, and then people get bothered that everyone's getting shit-faced on St. Paddy's Day, because it hypes up a stereotype. What do you do on Cinco de Mayo? Eat tortillas? No, you're fucking downing tequila. So, like, what's the big deal? All right, but the stereotype is stupid. But I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense because, like, also, like, I'm an alcoholic and, like, it runs, you know, in people's families and shit when they're Irish. But, I mean, other than that, you know, I'm not fucking, like, waking up in the morning and I start just gnawing on a potato. I like potatoes just as much as the next guy. I like potatoes as much as someone from Brazil. All right? Everyone likes potatoes. Okay? Everyone eats French fries and mashed potatoes just because I'm Irish. And, like, my grandparents came here 100 years ago on a boat. Doesn't mean I miraculously like potatoes more than the next guy. I think that's just a load of bullshit. And it's lame. You know? And, you know what I mean? That's like everyone in Colombia, you know, being, like, addicted to cocaine. I mean, maybe they are. I'd probably be. So, So yeah, cut the bullshit with that, all right? Yeah, no, it's kind of like when Irish people like pretend to like Irish shit because they're Irish. That like reminds me of like vegans. All right? Because you know vegans don't enjoy the food they eat. They can't. There's no fucking way. What are you eating, flax seeds and fucking tree bark, right? Or quinoa or quinoa or however douchey way you fucking pronounce it. There's no way you like I mean, it's a noble cause. All right, being a vegan, I get it. Okay, it makes sense, right? Cows are farting and shit with the methane. They take up a lot of water. Right? They're putting like chickens in cages and shit. Like, it's fucked up. I get it. I understand. I mean, I'm not fucking doing it. Right? And I understand why you're doing it. But I know the food you're eating sucks. So don't be posting pictures of your meals that you know you're not going to enjoy or deep down you're not enjoying. All right? I mean, like, maybe you do, but like, I doubt it. Right? Like, you wouldn't rather, like, you don't miss being 8 years old going to McDonald's? Bullshit. All right? You know what I mean? I guess like those documentaries, like those food documentaries, like those are always like turning people into like vegetarians and shit. That movie supersized me. All that does is make me want McDonald's. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck what you make it with. Like I it tastes good. I don't give a shit. Right? Like whatever. You're gonna live. Right? People eat McDonald's all the time and they live until like they're 80. You know what I mean? It's like not that big of a deal. So what if it's like pink paste? Or whatever the beef is. Whatever. Fuck it. Load me up with the pink paste. All right? I like it. Okay? You don't have to like it, but I like it. Right? So they're always like, you know, they're always like trying to post like, you know, fucking facts and like, you know, shit about the environment and shit. Like, stop trying to like shove an idea. I mean, yeah, I get it. Like, you're trying to like educate people, but people aren't gonna stop like eating bacon. It's never gonna happen. All right? Until like. I don't know, we all start dying off. People aren't gonna stop eating bacon, okay? They're not gonna stop drinking milk with hormones in it or whatever the fuck is the problem with that. And so like on Thanksgiving, don't try to pretend like you're not the most miserable person in that room. Okay? Probably getting made fun of by your drunk uncle because you're eating fucking tofu. All right? I'm sure that's a horrible time for you. You know, so just like don't hype it up. Don't make it. Don't pretend like you're enjoying yourself. I get it's a noble cause, but you don't have to. Don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to us. All right. So for any of you vegans out there, if you want to talk, if you want to vent about the shit that you're eating, I'm here, man. I'm here for you. Talk to me. All right. I want to be your friend. Okay. Just don't lie to me. You know, I don't deserve it. Right? Oh, you know what I fucking you know what I saw a story of? I didn't read the story. Okay, because like I'm more of like a headline kind of guy. I read the headlines, and then I kind of like just make up the story in my head with the information that I'm given. What am I gonna read every article in the world? Right? Who has the time for that? No one. I don't. So. It was this article, I don't know, because I just scroll through Yahoo, you know? And, like, I just read whatever it is. If it's, like, really interesting, I'll read it, but for the most part, you know, I don't have the time. I'm a busy guy, right? So, anyway, I saw a fucking article about how Shaq thinks the world is flat. Oh, I wrote it down. He goes, "You mean to tell me that China is underneath us?" Yeah, this is what, like, could you imagine being an astronaut and finding out, like, if the world was actually flat? Like, you'd be the only one that could prove that. I mean, besides, like, scientists and, like, actual fucking numbers and shit. But could you imagine, like, being an astronaut and you fucking launch up into the air, and then you look back and it's just fucking flat? Right? It's just, like, for miles. Or fuck, however long it'd be, probably. Like, what are they reading? I want to know. Like, I gotta look into this. What are they reading that convinces them that the world is flat? It was like Shaq. It was like that rapper B.O.B. They got someone else, like another victim with it. It's just like, it's incredible how like people are like convinced of shit. Like, you know, I see people on Facebook, and like the memes that they share, whenever I get like, you know, like the four, there'd be like four mass shootings, and then they would try to prove that like there's like what, a fucking actor in each of the, like of the mass shootings. So like somehow like every shooting's a fucking ploy, right? Like, what? Like you don't think that all those people are actually dead, right? What do you think, they're like hiding on an island? You know what I mean? Like, so people that share shit like that just blow my mind. You know, just how, like how gullible people can be. I mean, I'm gonna be honest, like, when I was like back in high school, I used to like scare the shit out of myself for like 6 months. Like that 2012 shit, I fucking freaked myself out. I freaked myself out. And then, I mean, obviously, like, I eventually like convinced myself otherwise. But that day, whatever day it was, like the week leading up to it, even though like, I had convinced myself that like the world wasn't gonna end, obviously, like I was still thinking about it. Like it was in the back of my mind. And then, like, I woke up the next, like, that day of, and I'm like, all right, yeah, like, I'm a fucking idiot, right? But then, like, that whole day still, I was still, like, looking up at the sky and, you know, just feeling for earthquakes or whatever, you know, any shit that would happen. I feel like a meteor is going to hit us eventually, right? Right? You see when, like when there's, like a comet shower or any of that, that's, like, a million fucking rocks flying around that we can see, like a million of them, right? So like, what if one of them gets in like in our orbit? We are fucked. I don't think that we're capable. Like, you ever seen Armageddon? Everyone's seen Armageddon. That shit's not happening. We are fucked. Fucked. If there's a comet or an asteroid coming at us, you know, the dinosaurs didn't fare so well when that happened. So, I mean, they didn't have spaceships, but I doubt that we could stop an asteroid. And I think it's going to happen eventually, right? But, like, I don't think fucking Nostradamus or some fucking dude from, like, 1,000 years ago is going to predict what's going to, like, how? How? You know? I hate it, like, those people have credibility. You know, you could guess anything and get it right eventually, right? So, that's just, like, like, psychics. You gotta be kidding me. People that believe in psychics or like Long Island Medium? Fuck, are you kidding me? That is the biggest crock of shit I've ever heard of in my life. Long Island Medium. Alright? Everyone knows someone that died. Alright? Everyone knows someone close to them that has died at some point if you're over the age of like fucking 12. Right? You know someone that died. So then she fucking narrows it down. She's like, yeah, I sense a female, right? Right? If she ever did that to me, even if what she was saying was right, if she was on fucking camera, I would be like, no, that's not right, right? Just say no to everything that she's saying until she starts crying, right? There's just no way. When do you listen to dead people? Like, do you hear them when you're trying to go to bed at night? Or it's only when you're in, like, that person's presence. So then whenever you go to the supermarket, you're just fucking hearing old fucking dead people, like, while you're waiting online, like, the person in front of you, like, you know his cousin died? How do you not drive yourself insane? Talking to dead people. Like, she should be either institutionalized or arrested for fraud. You know? What am I talking about, right? I mean, no, because that's true. That's a crock of bullshit. Long Island Medium or like psychics. Anyone that I would maybe pay like $10 for like a psychic just for shits and gigs. Right? But like, what if you pay someone a lot of money and they tell you that you're gonna like die in a year? Like, does that happen? Do psychics say that shit? Because that's fucked up. You can't just make shit up like that, right? Or tarot cards? What the fuck are those? You know? I mean, I don't know enough to talk about the subject, but I know it's a load of bullshit, alright? You don't talk to dead people, okay? That doesn't happen, alright? Oh, Because if, like, you go up to, like, a fucking 50-year-old, like, you automatically know that their parents are probably dead, right? Or one of them, right? Like, I'm 24. She can assume that, like, one of my grandparents died, right? One of them. One out of four. Those are pretty good odds. Right? So that's just a load of bullshit. Right? There's just no way. And people eat that shit up. People eat that shit up. The women, they got their fucking Kleenex next to them before the episode. And it's just a load of nonsense. And I've actually, because she lives like the town over from me. And she's got like a sign on her lawn saying no loitering, like no out, no, like no, you can't stand in front of the house and take fucking pictures. Like, go fuck yourself, lady. No one gives a shit, all right? I didn't drive down past her house purposely. I was doing something at a house down the block, and I saw like TV crews and shit. Like, her whole fucking garage is decked out with like studio shit. And who cares, right? I'm done talking about it. But yeah, Shaq's an idiot. Like, why? Even if you have some sort of like theory, okay? Even if you have like some sort of theory, there's no way you're convinced. And then even if you are, you don't go out loud. Like, if you're like a celebrity, you don't like go out and say, I think this. Like that B.O.B. guy, like he was making it seem like he was trying to educate us all about shit. Like as if he's the enlightened one and we're all just a bunch of retards. And I think that's just total nonsense. But in other news, who died? Some guy that I really just don't even give a shit. Oh, Chuck Berry. Right? Some dude. From the 50s. Like, he played the guitar. And of course, you know, everyone's, oh, I'm so upset. Oh, I can't believe this happened. People die. Okay? Like that whole shit, we're like, oh, 2016, I can't believe so many people died. You can't? You don't think old people die? Right? You didn't see Muhammad Ali coming? That dude was like a fish out of water, just fucking convulsing everywhere he was going. The guy probably wanted to die, right? And just couldn't say the words. Right? Like, that was time. It's time to go. Chuck Berry was 90 years old. 90 years old. He probably wanted to die too, like at that age. You know what I mean? Who else died? Who Prince? So many people got so upset about Prince. Who gives a shit? No one even knew he lived in Minnesota or wherever the fuck he lived, right? I knew like one song, that Purple Rain song, and like that's it. Like, who, I you know what I mean? Here's the thing. I know I sound like heartless right now, but here's the thing. If you're not going to be bothered or upset when I die, why the fuck would I care when you die? I think that's fair. I'm not going to affect my life for your death if you're not going to, if it's not, if you know, if it's not, wow, my vocabulary is great. Mutual. Nice. Yeah, there needs to be some sort of mutual understanding that we're both going to be upset when each other die. Okay? So I'm not going to take the time out. I can't even remember who else died last year. It was apparently like a million people. You know, I'm trying to think of like, if I've ever been upset over someone that I don't know dying. Robin Williams, that was upsetting. All right? But everyone was upset. And he was like still contributing to society. All right? He wasn't like, you know, fucking shaking or like living in a house in fucking Minnesota. Who the fuck lives in Minnesota? Right? Just fucking, who cares, right? Robin Williams, like, he was still acting, he was still around. You know, he was depressed and shit, but yeah, that was really upsetting when he left us. But everyone was upset about that, all right? Because if you're not upset that Robin Williams died, you're just an asshole. How hypocritical does that sound? But yeah, no, seriously, you're an asshole if you weren't upset when Robin Williams died, okay? That was upsetting. But like 90 years old, like when I'm 70, I'm clocking out. I'm done. I'm out of here. What for? What? What am I gonna get old for? So I can just fucking have my diaper change and just sit there and fucking wither away into the wind. You know what I mean? What's there to look forward to? Your bones break. You get sick. You get like tubes put in you and shit. Right? Unless you're like that 95-year-old woman that drinks red wine every day and like still masturbates. You know, and like those people live forever. But it's most likely not going to happen. You're most likely just going to die. You're going to like start calling your mailman, your wife, right? You fucking wake up. You're like, where the fuck am I? You know, I'm not looking forward to that at all. You know, obviously you get shoved in a home where you just go there to die, right? Or like, I don't want to like inconvenience my kids. So I'm thinking like 70, right? Like just, you know, go before I start hating my grandkids, right? Before they start hitting like preteens and I just die while hating them, right? Just go at 70. And I'm going to do some cool shit. I'm going to go out with a bang, right? Maybe like go try to fight the cartel, all strapped up, right? Or like go fight ISIS, because they're still going to be around probably when I'm like 90 or 70. Or like wrestle a bear, right? That's fucking badass. Right? Instead of dying of fucking kidney failure. You know what I mean? It's just like, you know, I don't know. I don't know if this is the word, ageist. Okay? All right? But, you know, and Nanny and Poppy, if you're listening right now, I apologize. Old people, like, shouldn't be driving cars. At all. Right? No, this is what I think people can drive cars. I think old people can drive cars. What I'm talking about is I think you should have to like retake your road test at some point. I mean, granted, like if I were to take the road test right now, I'd probably fail it, right? No one really remembers all the rules and shit, but like a lenient one. Not one about like rules, a fucking road test to prove that you can see and read signs, right? And like know where you are. They're a hazard on the, a lot of old people are a hazard on the road. Now, don't even call me a dick, because I know every single one of you has sat behind an old person and you've said under your breath, fucking old people. All right? You've done it. All right? So don't be thinking I'm a dick. All right? I'm just saying something that everyone thinks. Okay? Because they're a hazard on the road. They're driving like 20 miles an hour. Or they're driving on the wrong side of the road. They're never getting into the accident, right? You're getting yourself into an accident because they're just getting in the way. You try to drive around them, you hit a fucking semi. They're just killers. They're killers with driving machines. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't be able to drive when you're old. I think you should just be able to prove that you can see and read and like you're physically alert. Like 85-year-olds, you know, take the bus. Sorry, that's mean, but it's true. You know, that's just that's my hot take. Oh man. So yeah, I've been dropping some weight. You know, not to toot my own horn, but yeah, I've been down. I'm down like 40 pounds, and. I'm not doing it for any like sort of like specific reason. Like I just want to be lighter on my feet, you know. But back when I was like 285 and I started running on the treadmill, like I couldn't physically run on the treadmill. I would have to use the elliptical. I had to like lose like 10 pounds first because like my foot kept like sticking the fucking, like you know like the whatever the fuck it is that spins around. Like it was stopping every time my foot would land on it would stop and like I almost like broke my knee. It like I couldn't handle the weight. You know what I mean? So I had to use the elliptical for like the first 10 pounds. But now I'm fucking killing it, you know? I do like a mile in like 9 minutes, you know? I'm not tooting my own horn, all right? I'm just sharing the news with you guys, you know? And I don't know, I just didn't feel healthy. You know what I mean? I thought like when I was gonna stop drinking, I was just gonna naturally lose weight, but I just started eating like a fucking animal. And now I'm doing this bullshit diet where I only drink like protein shakes. Everyone's sick of listening to this because everyone that I know, I'm always bitching about it. I'm always like, oh man, I'm so fucking hungry, but like I can't stand it anymore. I'm losing my mind. I eat once. I am allowed to eat one meal, dinner, and it has to be like under 600 calories. Like that can't be healthy, right? I'm probably doing it wrong. It was like this. I was doing like this whole diet thing. It's like a month long, and I didn't read the instructions or whatever. I kind of just winged it, Like how bad can you just, consume this shit? I just know you can only have one meal a day, and like a banana. I can have like a banana. Who gives a fuck, right? Who cares? What I'm saying is, I've had people tell me, oh, now you could go to the beach. Like they thought I wasn't going to the beach because of my weight. No, I don't go to the beach because the beach sucks. All right? First off, going back to me being Irish, that's another thing. My fucking transparent skin, okay? I fry. I have about a 10-minute window out in the sun before I need to find cover. All right? Before third degree burns. All right? So that's why I don't go to the fucking beach. So I can sit underneath an umbrella and look like the biggest fucking loser or wear like a white t-shirt. Right? So I don't burn. Right? Or like, oh, I'm gonna wear sunblock. That shit gets it. It gets in your eyes. If you feel all lubey, you feel like all oiled up, right? Like you just fucking like you just came out of the womb. Ugh. And like it gets in my eyes. They always say every fucking sunproof, every sunblock says, oh, waterproof. Bullshit. I get fucking sunblock in my eyes every time I wear it. Every time. Why? So I can get sand in my food? Because I always get sand in my food when I go to the beach. It's like inevitable. It's everywhere. And if I get sand in my food, it's game over. The day's over for me. I'm pissed for like a week. Because I gotta eat, And like at the water, I'm gonna go to Jones Beach. Right? The undertow eats like 4-year-olds. And why? So I can get bitten by a shark? You know what I mean? And I'm not crazy. There's definitely sharks in the water now. Because you don't even know. Like the water's warm everywhere now. Fucking there's sharks everywhere. It's like a whale washed up. Right? In like Connecticut or some shit? Well, how the fuck does that happen? So, yeah. So like sharks. And like the water sucks. It's like brown. It's not like good. Seawater, and that gets in your eyes. You accidentally drink it. I just don't like the beach. All right. So it was just insulting for someone to think that I was losing weight so that I could finally go to the beach. No, I'm losing weight because I just want to fucking lose weight. All right, that's it. I don't have there's no some sort of hidden agenda. All right. You know what I mean? I was comfortable in my body beforehand. I just want to be healthier. All right. Yo, yeah, I don't like the beach. You know what else I don't like? I like hiking. I get asked to go hiking all the time. And it just blows my mind. First off, I got asked one time to go hiking in the middle of January. Like somewhere upstate. Why? So I can get eaten by a bear? Right? How do you know where bears live? You don't know where they live. They could be anywhere, right? And you fucking, I'm loud as shit. I wake one of them up while they're fucking hibernating, and they rip my fucking head off, or like I step on a mossy rock and snap my ankle, right? Hiking for what? For what? So what are you looking at? Oh, hey, that's a nice tree over there. You know what I mean? So you wait. So you can get poison ivy, right? Or like bitten by a snake. I'm gonna stick to the treadmill, all right? And especially in the winter. Oh, I'm not gonna go in the summertime either. There's never a time where I'm gonna be going hiking, all right? I don't like the beach, and I don't like hiking. But it's not like I'm like opposed to getting naked, right? Just ask the ladies. No, I'm a pool guy. I like the pool. I like a controlled setting, controlled environment, where I can't get like sand in my eyes. And I can like hop in the pool for 5 minutes, then I go and I hop in the AC inside, or I go underneath like some sort of canopy, so I'm not getting fried. Because you're on the beach, There's no shade. Where the fuck? You're on the beach. There's nowhere to go. Right? Unless you have your own umbrella. Right? Or one of those umbrella hats. Right? They still have those. So that's that. And, what else is going on? Amy Schumer stealing jokes. What time is it? Oh, fuck. It's been 35 minutes already. Shit. I don't know how long I wanted to do this for. Because everyone's been saying that, it was too long. I think people will be more inclined to listen to a shorter thing. But there's no, like, beginning or end. There's no, like, climax to this. So you could turn it off right now. And I could talk for another 10 minutes, and you wouldn't even like tell you you wouldn't be missing anything, you know. So you could just turn it off whenever. I don't. I'll stop talking when I want, which will probably be soon. But I don't want to, you know. I don't want to go too long, right? You know. But what else? Oh yeah. So you know, oh, fuck. What was I saying? Oh, Amy Schumer stealing jokes. And, I don't know how I feel about it. I don't think, I didn't watch her special. Of course, I don't, like, do any sort of research before I start, you know, running my mouth, on this podcast. But I saw, like, a clip of, like, her, like, the comparisons of, like, one joke. And, like, I guess it was kind of obvious. I just can't imagine, first off, if you need to steal other people's jokes, you should stop being a comic, right? If that's what you need to do in order to do stand up, like that's kind of fucked up. Like like blatant ones that you're gonna get caught for. How do you? I don't know. I've always liked her. I always like, you know. I put my fist on my vagina. Like, I mean, those jokes kind of get old, right? But like, she did well in that one movie that I don't even remember the fucking name of. What was that movie she did with Bill Hader? Whatever the fuck it is. It was good. Like, I thought it was good. I think she did a good job, but she acted and shit, and, you know. And, like, I don't, like, you know. I know, like, comics. I probably, like, know comics that, like, know her. But she, like, you know, it was, like, inspiring almost, you know. Like, back in the day because, you know, she, like, had, like, an open mic in Brooklyn. And she was always just doing mics. And she worked her way up, you know, and it's, like, inspiring. So it sucks that, you know, she's just getting shit on now. Her and Ronda Rousey, they were, like, on top of the world 2 years ago. Now Amy Schumer is just completely just getting shit on. And Ronda Rousey got her face pummeled in, like, twice. Right? I mean, I don't really know anything about UFC, but I thought she was a good fighter. I guess because I just listened, I guess, from just reading, like, headlines like I do. I just assumed she was a good fighter, right? I saw one fight where she, like, got that lady into an armbar in like 9 seconds or whatever the fuck, but apparently that's her only move. I don't know, but I just feel bad for these females, almost like they should have just, like, you know, like if you knew you weren't a good comic and you couldn't, like, think of, like, your own jokes, and you knew that you only had a few moves and you weren't that good of a fighter, leave on top, right? Like, they both could have just kept acting and, like, you know, not put yourself in a position to now. They both. Ronda Rousey's done, right? And Amy Schumer's, I would assume, is fucked. You know? That's, like, the only thing you can't do when you're a comic. You can make rape jokes. You know? I have, like, a 10-minute bit about, just about ISIS. You know? I have this whole bit about autism that I'm too afraid to do. I'm gonna do it eventually. It's fucked up. But, like, there's not much you can't do. You ever heard of Bob Saget? Or Gilbert Gottfried? These, like, just crazy shit that you say. You could say anything, right? But you can't, like, you can't take someone else's material. So, I mean, I don't know. That was just something I guess I just wanted to get off my chest because I don't know how to feel about it. Because, like, if you know you're going to get caught, why do it? Like, hire a writer. Get a writer. Right? Get a ghostwriter or something. Or maybe imagine she did get a ghostwriter and that ghostwriter stole jokes. Oh, man. That'd be rich. That would be funny. Ha. What else do I want to talk about? Let's keep it topical. Right? Let's keep it topical. Let's talk about March Madness. All right. Let's do that. Let's talk about something that I know fucking nothing about. Okay. March Madness. It's fuck college basketball, and fuck your brackets. All right, that's what I think. Who has the time? Honestly, to be so so educated in college basketball that you think that you can make like yourself a decent bracket. How many fucking teams are there? Like 100 or some shit, right? And people are like, oh, darn, ah, oh, there goes my bracket. Of course there goes your bracket. You would think it's such a waste of time. After, like, the first 6 games, every bracket's lost. Like, every bracket's lost. And, like, right? Well, I mean, I don't really know what I'm talking about, but I'm pretty sure that's, like, it gets up there. It's, like, 80-something percent of all brackets are lost after, like, the first 7 games. What's the point? I don't know. I mean, maybe the point isn't to have the perfect bracket. I guess maybe the point is just to see how many teams you... I mean, I get it. It's fun. It doesn't enthuse me. College basketball. Just basketball in general. I mean, I appreciate the sport. You know, the thing with football, the reason why I like football so much is that you never know what's going to happen. You know what I mean? Like, you just, like, someone could die, right? You know, you can see someone's leg get snapped in half. You know, someone just like, you know, they start throwing up inside their helmet because they have a concussion and they start crying and they're like, where am I? You know, it's always something interesting, right? Some fucking fan runs out on the field naked or whatever. I mean, that doesn't really happen often. But just cool shit. Cool shit, like cool hits and whatever the fuck. I mean, basketball is just quite repetitive. You either shoot a 3... or you shoot a 2, right? Is that the lingo? Or you dunk it, right? I mean, dunks are cool, but even then, you've seen every type of dunk. Steph Curry's already shot it from like half court. You've already seen it, you know. You've already seen it. I don't know. I mean, NBA is cool, but like, how do you know so much about so many sports, right? I don't know. That's my hot take, March Madness. No, they should make it more interesting, right? They should make it more interesting. Like 1 minute in every period, like another ball shoots out onto the court. And they start playing with 2 balls. And everyone's just freaking out. I was like, what's going on? Oh man, what do we do, right? That would be nuts. That would be crazy. That's some type of shit that I would watch. You know what? You know what would make me watch soccer? If they cut the fucking field in half. All right? The field is too big. No? Those poor guys, they run like in a combined like 20 miles in a game. Like, you would think, when did they make that the regulation size? Because you would think that once that was, like, the preferred regulation size, what, like, 300 fucking years ago, that after, like, the first year, they get together and they're like, all right, no one's fucking scoring. Let's switch it up. That's another thing that could be played with 2 balls, right? Put 3 balls out. The more goals, the better. No, I would assume. I don't. You're just going to, like, if a football game ended 0-0, you'd be pissed. You'd be like, wow, I just wasted 3 hours. It's even worse when you're watching soccer, right? Because at least, like, at least people get, like, hurt and shit in football. Like, in soccer, you step on their shoelace, they fucking, grown-ass men, you step on their shoelace, they face plant to the ground, they start crying. Like, it's grass. Even if you sidekick me, or slide kick me, or whatever. Like, yeah, I know. I've heard, like, soccer, oh, that shit fucking hurts, bro. Yeah, I know it hurts. You're getting a cleat into your leg. I get it. But you're going to start crying? Right? You know what I mean? Like, you see their faces as they're falling down slow motion. It's pathetic. Man up. All right? And you fucking throw out the yellow and red cards. Don't even, what for? Why? Because it's entertaining? Someone fell down? That's great. They should all be sly tackling each other. All of them. When you don't have the ball, you should just be going after someone and sly tackling them. All right? And like, for every person you knock down, you get like a gold star or something at the end of the game. Okay? So that's how soccer should be played. Cut the field in half. Because these poor guys are winded. You kick the ball. You run it all the way down the field. You lose control of it. The fucking goalie just kicks it back to the other side of the field. Now you gotta run back to the other side of the field. And then the goalie over there kicks it back. Like, what the fuck? Right? It should be like the size of a football field or smaller. Because, like, the net's already big enough. How much bigger are you going to make the net? You know what I mean? I feel like you should be scoring more. Or maybe there should be less people on the team. On the field. I don't know. I just know it's boring as shit. So what was I saying? Oh, yeah. No, it should be like NFL Street, too. With fucking walls. It should be a shorter field and walls. So that the ball never goes out of bounds. The ball goes out of bounds way too much. The field's so big. How is a ball constantly going out of bounds? I'll give them one thing. I mean, they run a lot. I'll give them one thing. Sometimes it amazes me how they, like, stop the ball from, like, going out of bounds and shit. Right? That's impressive. I mean, I'm gonna give them credit, like, where credit's due. But the sport itself, you know. And, like, why is a World Cup every 4 years? It's not like the Olympics where you need to fucking, like, make a whole gymnastics court and, like, a swimming pool and shit. You need a fucking ball and some grass to play. What do you need 4 years to prep? Everyone loves the World Cup. Have it every year. Have it every summer. Why not? What are you, diluting it? Sport already sucks. You know? Because I'd root for USA. You know, when they played. But I'm not watching the Milwaukee Storm. Or whatever the fucking weird name. Like, I can't even name any names on the... not one. You know? Yeah, so that's that. And, I don't know. I think I might get out of here. What do we got? We're at 47 minutes. I think that's long enough. Right? I think I've covered all the bases here. You know, I'm glad I can, I'm glad I could, educate you guys. Oh, by the way, the McGregor-Mayweather fight, that's never fucking happening, so don't get excited. It's not going to happen, all right? It's not happening. If Manny Pacquiao can't beat Mayweather in boxing, what the fuck makes you think Conor McGregor can beat him in boxing? Like, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. Mayweather's going to do that fucking lame-ass shit where he just fucking ducks, throws, like, the jab to get the point, and then hides again, and then, like, fucking jabs to get the point. Like, that's just, he's the most boring fighter ever. Right? And then Conor McGregor is going to get fucking frustrated and end up kicking him in the jaw. That's what's going to happen. He's going to fucking headbutt him in the face because he's going to be getting so frustrated. He's not going to be able to land a punch on Mayweather. And he's just going to fucking kick him in the ribs. That's what's going to happen. Because there's no way. First of all, it's not happening. All right? Because they've been talking about it forever now. And they're probably just making money off of talking about it. They probably got together like last year. And they're like, hey, let's fool all these idiots into thinking we're going to fight. And let's make, because you know how Mayweather needs money. Like, he doesn't even need money to fight. You know? Like, he doesn't even need the money. What are you doing? You know? Just retire already. God. Right? I don't know. On that note, I'm gonna dip out of here. Whatchamacallit? Fuck, I wanted to plug this in the beginning. I'm doing this upcoming Sunday, March 26th at 1 p.m. Johnny McGorry's Pub. It's in Massapequa, I believe. St. Baldrick's. I'm getting my head shaved for childhood cancer research. Whatchamacallit, if you want to donate, please go on my Facebook, Sean Kearns. Or you go on my my Instagram, I got the link there. Showing my No, fuck that. I'm not, I don't want to tell. I need a new Instagram name. All right, because my Instagram name is Shoney Swags, and I did it when I was 19. And like, don't get me wrong, like it's okay, but like I'm 24 now, and I can't be having my fucking name Shoney Swags. I gotta change it, right? But like, I go and I try to get the domain, the handle Sean Kearns, and I can't do it. Someone else has it. Some fucking shithead with like four followers has it, and he has a private account, private profile. So I don't know. I can't even change it. Or like my Twitter. Excuse me. My Twitter is Kern Daddy. Excuse me. Because I can't get Sean Kearns. Some asshole in Ireland has Sean Kearns, and like it's impossible to get your name. So what am I gonna fucking? I'm gonna have like my name like Sean Kearns like fucking like 72, right? Like I'm in one of those like to catch a predator fucking chat lines. No. So it's annoying. So I got just like my fucking Instagram is Shoney Swags. I want to change it. I want to like I don't want to do Sean Kearns comedy. That's lame. Or Kearns comedy. Fucking lame. I just want to show occurrence. I should have it. I want it. Especially when the people that are using it aren't even using it. It's a waste. I'm calm. All right? But yeah, follow. Oh, so yeah, go on my Facebook, Sean Kearns, and yeah, donate. Click the link because I've raised $700 already, but I'm trying to get to 1200, and I'm fucking shitting my pants about shaving my head. Shitting my pants because I'm afraid it's not gonna grow back. All right, you know what I mean? I mean, besides wanting to like, you know, obviously like raise money for childhood cancer research, I kind of wanted to see what the inevitable is gonna look like, you know, with a bald head. So I figured I might as well do it now, right? Check it out, get like a little preview so I can prepare myself for the future, because you know, it's just in the cards for me. You know what I mean? Like I've already accepted it. What are you gonna do? Just fucking stare at yourself in the mirror every day and just watch yourself become less attractive? No, you gotta fucking own it. So I'm gonna so yeah. Wait. Yo. So yeah. So I'm gonna get my head shaved Sunday. Jesus Christ, I got sidetracked for a second. So go on my Facebook and hey, if you're listening, and we're not friends on Facebook, and you happen to go on my Facebook to look at the link, hey, friend request me. I'm always down to meet new people. I want to be your friend, all right? Even though there's only 10 people listening, and I know them all. Twitter, the SKS podcast, the Sean Kearns show on Facebook, the Sean Kearns show on SoundCloud. And I gotta make a new YouTube account, but it'll most likely be the Sean Kearns show on YouTube. And that is it. I'm getting the fuck out of here. Nice, 50, you know, 50 something minutes. That's pretty good. All right. Till next time, guys. Thanks. See you.